know, me and my kids struggled with homelessness for so long. We finally got our house, and then, boom, we got to leave.
Tonight, a few families living in Durham's McDougal Terrace are back in their homes after spending weeks living in hotels. CBS 17's Zach Dahlheimer has more from Durham.
How does it feel standing in your living room again?
It feels different. I feel like I just moved in.
For Teela Shaw and her five kids, this Valentine's Day is special, moving back into her home at Durham's McDougal Terrace.
It's a breath of fresh air.
The start to their new year came with adversity, having to move out of their home due to issues throughout their unit.
Water heater leaking. I had that was leaking. My stove was leaking. All my ceilings were leaking. In the bathroom, just mold everywhere.
Spending weeks at a hotel.
Month and some change.
She tells us being out of her home was difficult, but all too familiar.
Feeling like we're homeless again. You know, me and my kids struggled with homelessness for so long. We finally got our house, and then, boom, we got to leave. I had to get mental help, get my kids mental help, because it's just, you know, we felt boxed in. Okay, how y'all feel being home?
Great.
But now they're all smiles. Durham housing officials say 8 apartments passed inspection and units will have new heaters, water heaters, and stoves. Shaw believes officials are addressing this the right way.
I feel like they're doing what they need to do, you know, as far as getting people back in their homes safely instead of painting over stuff and just rigging stuff up. They're actually doing what they're supposed to do.
With new appliances, Shaw and her family are ready for a new beginning with peace of mind in home sweet home.
That was Zach Dahlheimer reporting. Now, Durham housing officials say families moving back in today will have to leave again sometime in the future for 3 to 5 days for electric work to be done on those homes. We're told the next group will be able to come home next week.